I get where I'm going, on the far side of the sky. The first thing that I'm gonna do is spread my wings and fly. I'm gonna land beside a lion and run my fingers through his mane, where I might find out what it's like to ride a drop of rain. Yeah, when I get where I'm going, there'll be only happy tears. I will shed the sins and struggles I have carried all these years, and I'll leave my heart wide open. I will love and have no fear. Yeah, when I get where I'm going, don't cry for me down here. I'm gonna walk with my granddaddy, and he'll match me step for step. And I'll tell him how I've missed him every minute since he left. And then I'll hug his neck. Yeah, when I get where I'm going, there'll be only happy tears. I will shed the sins and struggles I have carried all these years, and I'll leave my heart wide open. I will love and have no fear. Yeah, when I get where I'm going, don't cry for me down here. So much pain and so much darkness in this world we stumble through. All these questions I can't answer, and so much work to do. But when I get where I'm going, and I see my Maker's face, I'll stand forever in the light of His amazing grace. Yeah, when I get where I'm going, oh, when I get where I'm going, there'll be only happy tears. Hallelujah. I will love and have no fear.
Hello, can you hear me? There we go. Hello, my name is Brian Green, and I'm a caregiver, and I will always be a caregiver. I would like to thank all of you present today for being a part of Relay Nation, and together, we are unstoppable in the fight against cancer. The video you just watched was a video made for my wife, Allison Green, who passed away this year on March 1st after a courageous and inspirational 2-year battle with cancer. Allie and I met in 2002 through mutual friends at a country concert. Country fans? Yes. On April 16th, 2005, we married and began our journey as a married couple. On November 5th, 2007, we were blessed with our beautiful daughter, Riley, and we couldn't have been happier. Our life as a family was perfect and going great until December 13th of 2008. Allie started complaining about a side ache she was experiencing, and a few days later, she went to the doctors to get it checked out. She went through several tests and doctor's visits, and in January of 2009, she was told that she had colon cancer. We didn't believe the doctors because how could it be that at the young age of 29, she had cancer? On February 3rd of 2009, Allie had surgery where they removed 6 to 8 inches of her colon and confirmed that she did have cancer and the cancer had spread into her liver and one of her lungs. We, of course, were very upset and numb, but we knew that the fight was on and we had to get ready mentally for the fight. One thing that you need to know about Allie is she would do anything for anybody and would always put herself second to help others. Allie didn't enjoy confrontations at all and was now confronted with the biggest fight of her life. During Allie's 2-year battle with cancer, she absolutely blew my socks off with how tough, determined, confident, and relentless she was on fighting back against her cancer. I always told Allie that she was an inspiration to everybody that knew her and that the way she was fighting would make a difference in people's lives. Whenever I told her this, she would sometimes reply that she didn't want the attention and she only wanted to be done with chemo and this cancer crap and just be a loving mother and wife. She would not let cancer alter her lifestyle, and in fact, she would add more to her already busy schedule. During the first year of going through chemo treatments every other week, if you would have walked by Allie, you would have noticed that she was battling cancer because she would always have her big, beautiful smile on display. That is another thing you need to know about Allie. She was always smiling, even on chemo days. Due to the side effects of chemo, Allie started losing her hair and was very upset. And I know all you ladies understand, you guys love your hair. She loved her hair, but it got to the point where she needed to shave it off. So I grabbed my clippers and shaved her head. Allie looked in the mirror and told me, "Now we have the same haircut, honey." We took a picture with her phone and she sent it out to her family, and of course she had a big smile on her face. She had no problem rocking the new hairdo and she looked great. When Allie started chemo in May of 2009 at St. Joseph's Cancer Pavilion Center, we were handed a flyer, and that flyer had information about a colon cancer awareness support group that meets once a month at St. Joseph's. So we started going to these meetings for support and to see how others are getting through the fight against cancer. So we walked into the meeting room and noticed that it was a room full of people our grandparents' age. And Allie and I looked at each other and thought, oh, I think maybe we're in the wrong room. The host of the group asked Allie if she needed help, and Allie replied, "Is this the colon cancer support group?" And the host replied, "Yes, it is." Allie smiled at the host and said, "I guess we're in the right spot then." The host dropped her mouth and was shocked at what Allie just said, but we proceeded to sit down and we had our first meeting. On the second or third meeting, there was a guest speaker from the American Cancer Society, and they talked about this event called the Relay for Life. And Relay for Life, please, give me a clap. And it sounded very interesting and fun to us. So Allie got on the computer the next day and noticed that Anaheim Hills was going to be having their first Relay for Life event in July of 2009. We signed up in the hopes of raising money to find a cure for cancer for others, but more selfishly, to find a cure for Allie. We also thought it would be a lot of fun getting all of our family and friends together for a little bit of exercise and cancer awareness. The name of our team was Team Allie, Believe. And the way the team name came to be was after Allie had surgery in March of 2009, we had a lot of friends that were kind of questioning and second-guessing where should we go for treatments and what hospital to go to, what cancer center. And we sat down in her recovery room, and all she said to me was, "I just need people to believe in me and believe that I am going to beat this and believe that I will be healthy." And that was the beginning of Team Allie Believe. I had T-shirts and wristbands made up with Team Allie Believe on them, and Believe was the way we lived our life from that point on. So much so that Allie got a Believe tattoo on her foot, I got a Believe tattoo on my arm, and Allie's mom actually got a Believe tattoo. Allie and I always believed that she would be cancer-free. We never lost sight of that goal. In fact, Allie is cancer-free right now. And she did beat her cancer, or she did beat her fight against cancer, because she didn't let cancer dictate how she was going to live her life. She lived her life the way she wanted to, and that was living life to the fullest. I couldn't be more proud of the person Allie was. When it comes to the caregiver role, you are wearing a lot of different hats, with the biggest one being the number one supporter of your loved one. You are also on the run all of the time, which can be tiresome and difficult. As a caregiver, you also need to make sure you take care of yourself and get the support that you need, and talk about things that are on your mind. Now, I wasn't the best guy when it came to talking about what I was dealing with, because I wanted everything to be focused on Allie and all the energy pointed towards Allie. But when I did need to talk, I have my support group with me who helped me get through things. And they're here tonight, and I want to thank Allie's mom, Joanne. My dad, Jerry. My mom, Bridget. My sister-in-law, Heather. And my partner of 4 years at work, Randy. My best friend of 26 years, Jason. And my older brother, 34 years, Richard. These were the guys I called on when I needed to talk about stuff. And I would like to thank all of you for being there, not only for Allie, but for me as well. While Allie was going through her fight with cancer, she stated that after she was cancer-free, she wanted to have a huge party in a big red barn. And we both decided that if we were going to have this huge party, well, we needed to have our favorite country artist there, Brad Paisley. We both thought, wow, imagine if we could make that happen. That would be the best cancer-free celebration party ever. After Allie had passed, I knew that I needed to make sure that we had a party in a big red barn at Strawberry Farms to celebrate Allie's life. So as we were sitting around the table figuring everything that we needed to do, at the end, my best friend Jason asked, "Hey, is there anything else you need?" And I replied, "Oh yeah, can you get me Brad Paisley for the party?" Jason did exactly what you guys did, chuckled and said, "Oh, okay." The next day, he told his wife Erin and his sister Jen that I wanted Brad Paisley to perform at Allie's party. And that's when Erin and Jen made the video that you guys just saw, "We Believe in Allie, Do You Brad Paisley?" And that video proceeded to get posted, blasted on Brad Paisley's Facebook page, his Twitter account, and within 12 hours of the video being sent out, I received a phone call from Brad's publicist, and she indicated that Brad wanted to talk to me and asked if it would be all right. I said no. And he... later on that day, I got a call from Brad, and we had a great conversation talking about Allie and life. He also told me that he was going to be in town and asked if it would be okay if he played at Allie's party. Brad wanted to play for Allie because Allie inspired him to be there, and he thought Allie was just an amazing and wonderful person. To this day, Allie continues inspiring people and making a difference in people's lives. You have to live life to the fullest and take advantage of it while we are still here. Here's a quote that Allie gave to a clothing designer. Believe in yourself. Believe that you are capable of anything. Believe that your positive attitude will inspire others as you achieve wellness. Believe you have a choice how you experience this crazy roller coaster ride called life. Believe in your dreams. Allie and I were together for 8.5 years, and it was the best 8.5 years of my life. We had the best times. We made great memories. We traveled a lot. We traveled more when she was diagnosed with cancer than we did before, and we already traveled a lot before. So we went all over the place. My partner can testify to that because I was never at work. I'm very proud of Allie in the fight that she had. And like I said, she's going to continue inspiring people. And she's going to touch people's lives. And she's going to make people realize, hey, you got to live life. Even if you have cancer, you need to live it. Go out there and believe in yourself, and you're going to beat cancer. And I'm just honored that I was actually lucky to have Allie by my side for 8.5 years. She was an absolutely wonderful and amazing person. So I also have our little daughter, Riley. Come here, baby. Come here. Say hello to everybody. Blowing kisses. Keep blowing kisses. Blowing kisses. Give them thumbs up. No? Okay. This is my little Allie Jr. She's a beautiful person. She's got an extremely big heart, just like her mom does. And she just wants people to be happy, and she makes people be happy. And I am, when we had Riley, a year later is when Allie got diagnosed. And we were lucky that we had Riley, because that gave Allie a reason to wake up every morning and be a mom. And she was a great mom, to be a mom to our little girl, Riley. And after Allie passed, I'm lucky that I have my Riley, because she's going to get me through a lot of times. And she's just a blessing. And I love you, honey.
I love you, too.
Thank you. Say hello to everybody. Okay, hi. You want kisses? I know my time's expired, and I apologize that. I'll just be one more quick minute. My goal is I want more cancer survivors. I want to be surrounded by more cancer survivors. My dad's a cancer survivor. My sergeant who's here with us tonight is a cancer survivor. My sister's sister-in-law is a cancer survivor. And my commander at work is a cancer survivor. I want to be surrounded by more cancer survivors. And I also want more money to be raised, so we won't have to lose more mothers, more fathers, more sisters, more brothers, and grandparents. And I don't want Riley to have to worry about cancer when she gets older. I want her to have a cancer-free life and not have to deal with this in her future. So thank you guys very much for listening to me. Thanks for letting me extend it a little bit. And thank you for seeing who my wife, Allie, was and the person that she was. And I'd also like to thank all my Team Allie members here tonight. So everybody stand up. Team Allie. Clap. Thank you, guys. Say bye-bye. Thank you.